What's up everybody, welcome back to my kitchen where safety is number one priority, and today we're going to put to the test 5 more kitchen gadgets. Let's see what I got this time. For the first gadget I got here, pump and lock, new invention in vacuum container. So it's supposed to store food for very long time. I really like the metal container right here. Probably stainless steel, but the best part about it, that is built-in vacuums or pumps, I would say. A lot of times you have to have a separate pump and pumps always get lost, or you have more space. Let's say you have leftover chicken wings, you can put them in there. Then we're gonna close it and lock it. And lock it. Oh, you wanna press it a little bit. Okay, and then this right here pumps it. How cool is that? I like it that it's metal, so you can put really hot stuff in there without worrying it melting the plastic. And whenever you're done, just fold it this way, put it away. Okay, whenever you're ready to eat, I'm pretty sure all you have to do is just pull this up, air comes up, and then you just open it and lift it. Wow, super awesome. I really like this containers way more than having pump laying around somewhere that you don't even know where it's at. Pump it, put it away. Let's try to remove this. No way it's gonna come off. Press this again, release the air, you see the lid came off. But also there's very unique for this kind of containers, it seals it up really good too. So I would say this is the best vacuum containers I ever seen. For the next gadget I got here, spiralizer by this brand right here. And this is probably the most high quality spiralizer I've ever seen, because it's metal, usually it's plastic, so obviously we cut the end of it, and it looks like a little spring in here. Just find the middle and go through. I'd say it's middle enough. And then the best part is it's just satisfying. Stick your finger in here and go like that. Because it's falling down a little bit, I think it's best to hold it this way and then go like that. Whoa, look how cool that is. Let's see if I can do it all the way. This is so cool. Telling you, this knife is so sharp. Okay, that's as deep as we're going to go. We'll have to cut it. And check this out. This is so awesome. You can garnish stuff, whatever. Next, we're gonna try it out with a potato. Put it in and go like that. Again, the best to hold it this way. You know, you can do spiralized chips potato. Wow, I have put to the test so many spiralizers. I would say this is the best and cheapest too. A lot of times you can buy very expensive spiralizers, they work, but they're so expensive. This is so simple, and as you can see, it works. I can almost go all the way through the whole potato. So I'm gonna break it off, and let's see. Look at that, this is so cool. Next gadget we got here, grater zoom. Works with garlic, ginger, chocolate, and more. So we're gonna try it out this time with ginger. Let's see if it works. Okay, this is actually a little bit different what I'm used to. Press it right here, remove it. Wow, very nice. There's a spring, whoops, that is gonna push away whenever we stick whatever garlic and whatever else we stick in there. Stick it into here. One more time. Locks in pretty good now. This is too slippery, seems like. If you spin it this way, it's going to slice. If you spin it this way, it's going to grate. Okay, it's spinning now and grating it. Okay, it's just hard to begin it, but there you go. Okay, once you had enough, you open this up and you open it this way, and look at that. little bit of piece is going to get stuck in here. The only problem is taking it stuff out from here. I guess you could just, ooh, be careful, this sharp blade inside of them. And boom, you got here shredded ginger. Let's try to slice it instead. Okay, it's spinning. Let's see if it's gonna slice it up. Zoom in at it a little bit closer. You see how it spins? Ginger does not get sliced. It's mostly too grated because it just got all mushed up. So I wouldn't call it a slicer so much. It works better as a grater. That's it. Slicer does not work that well. For the next gadget I got here, spin out strainer. Let's see what it's all about. So you press it all the way and it locks, kind of. I guess you gotta press it to unlock it, but it doesn't really lock it super good. And then it spins out like that. Looks like a good idea, but what my concern is, there's little steps right here. If you're going to stain the macaroni or whatever, will it go through here? Let's find out. Also, it is very, very big. Who stains such a big pot? I would definitely would make it maybe double the size, smaller. But the handle right here is super comfortable. The only way I can set it up this way, and it is super hot macaroni over here. Let's try to stain it and see what happens. Okay, there goes nothing. Medium pot. And I'm losing macaroni. So that's what I was worried about. It's flexing a little bit. You see, if I shake it up, macaroni falling out. Very cool idea, but does not work super well. I think it's just too big. They should have made it much, much smaller. Okay, let's see if I, but yeah. Let me know in comments below, what do you think about this thing? I really like it because now you can store it, put it away very small. I just don't think it should be spin out so big to where it's like quadruple the size of the pot. It's almost uncomfortable because of that and flimsy. Look how flimsy that is. And for the last gadget, we got right here this brand. It's a one-hand pepper grinder. Instead of holding it and twisting it, you have to use two hands. This right here looks like spins plenty. And my favorite part is it goes away all the way back to where you can break up the pepper. You can make it bigger, smaller, medium by twisting it right here. You see, there's a dot bigger and smaller. Let's do medium. And as you can see, there's paper falling out. Let's do the biggest. Biggest kind of getting stuck, looks like, to where the handle stops, doesn't open all the way. I think it works best on a medium and a small. That way it does not get stuck. The handle doesn't open all the way. Oh, you see what I'm saying? It's stuck right here, and that's why you kind of get readjusted. So, a little bit of a fail. What happened? Did it break already? What kind of gadget is this that doesn't work already? There you go. And this side works. You see there's a blade inside of it coming out, in and out. Those pellets goes in them and chopping it. It's especially convenient whenever it's a buffet style. You grabbing the pepper, holding a plate with one hand, and then you wanna put some pepper on. You just squeeze it like that. I think it grinds really good. Especially whenever you don't have a place to put the plate down and go like that. Pretty awesome. I feel like there is a place to improve it because the pepper coming out a bit slower than I thought it would. But still, very convenient. Oops. Let's say I wanna rinse few grapes. Let's see how this thing will work. Okay, first of all, it works like a ball. Okay, now the coolest thing. All you have to do is just flip it, whoops. Flip it all the way around. Make sure you don't spill it like I just did. Much easier to use two hands, but I gotta film with one hand all the way through. Then hold it right here, and then flip it over and shake it. So that way all the water is out.
This is just very strange. Look at that. You have this weird ball.
And you spin it again.
Very, very unique ball. Don't you guys think? And now you have very fresh and clean anything you need to clean. Very nice.
Well guys, that's pretty much it. Let me know in comments below which gadget was your favorite. Don't forget the thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.